Yeah, and we also felt that schools need to respond individually because, like yourself, a large number of wider schools felt the same as yourself, but some felt differently when we looked at the worked examples. So I think our view would be to support what Andrew's proposal is, that we encourage individual schools to respond, because certainly the Norton and Leeson mini cluster would agree exactly what.
I think we're at schools that are very highly priority on it.
Meeting we have a report which is also to that, given the total sort of
We're very fortunate to have a service that knows our school really well. We're one of the few of that, isn't it? Thank you.
the unknown concept of the environment that we're working in, the context of the school, the amount of work we're doing within the school, and we came up with a judgment of the school based on five stars, which is saying, you know, if you know a character of the life, you change the way you measure it. So nothing's got there, nothing's going to be baseline. But if you don't go past, you get that. But, so within the offer, you just have to go, we've got people within the offer that really understand us. Go outside and get a little bit of a which is everything I was ahead of the last time. So that was the conversation. But however, what I'm trying to say is going outside, you don't really understand the context of work.
Just to back that up again, it says intervention in more schools, as I said, more and more schools are becoming more and more. In fact, every school is vulnerable, and we do need that backup, and we do need that support, no matter what last year's outcomes are, this year's outcomes are completely different kind of situation.
Would it be possible then, Chair, to be able to look for these savings elsewhere?
Yeah.
there are some mixed views in primary now, but what primaries have generally agreed with their clusters is that we would like to give the CRT another year if possible to see how we structure the process, see what the service could look like. Just to add some clarity to that, yes, the consultation is going ahead and I'm part of it, but the clusters have only been consulted on what's on here, which is the reduction of £120,000, and certainly there is a will to see CLCs continuing for the time being and then review it again as we said we would, but the £120,000 they didn't know about, so that was what we thought we were discussing this tonight. Not whether they were closing or not. CLCs. I mean, we feel very strongly, and I know that we, for example, have the CLC staff in today doing work with our children, and we could not replicate it if we didn't have the CLCs. And they have been absolutely blown away by the work. So, you know, there's two sides to the argument at the end of the day, and I know we're due to look at this again. I think, is it in the new year, January? So, you know, then we can discuss again whether the CLCs stay or go. But at the minute, I bring us back to this paper for tonight of £120,000.
Thank you.
SDs is in the picture, and we will pay 8, Halton pay between 7 and 25, Cheshire pay 13, and that goes with children not just in the special school sector, but children in base provision in primary and secondary as well. And we've got a tune of 600,000, suddenly gives a little clarity in the way to address that topic either today or in the future once it's gone, it's gone. The special school will also face an increased cost of the TA and PAD. The TA2 is now funded by 2,500 each member of staff, and considering the amount of staff we have in the special school sector and in the primary base and primary and secondary base provision, it has a huge impact upon budgets. We just felt that that was a huge amount to come out of one sector.
Does that mean that we fund more cases? As Margaret was saying, in comparison to the majority, some of our cases are top ups less, but we're spending more on our allocation.
What's your factor? Is it to spend more on having
missing obviously 2 months.